Hello everyone, my name is Arnab Bhattacharji. I welcome you all to my official YouTube channel, Imperial Education. As we know that today we are having very important topic, that is formal and business letter writing. Earlier we have discussed about this also, but later now we are going to see the format. Okay, earlier we have discussed that what are the things, what are the do's and what are the don'ts of business letter. Now, as you know about this, all these things, that what are the do's, what you need to do and what you don't need to do. Okay, now we are going to see what is the format, in which format do you need to write, because some of the things which you need to follow very strictly. So first thing that I again urge you everyone, that please do subscribe to our channel, because more you subscribe to the channel, we will bringing more important videos which will be very helpful to you. And always we are working hard to make you feel very good, very comfort, so that you will be learning good. Okay, whatever the topics we are bringing you that are very important in your life. So let us start with the topic. We are going to learn the format. So in format, what are the parts? Because let me tell you that I have divided all the business letter parts, whatever the format is, divided basically into 10 parts. Okay, this 10 is part are very important part. So before we start, let me tell you there are three sections that earlier also we have discussed. Earlier, first when we started this format, first format that we used to do in earlier times when we were in school, especially that time we used to do indented format. Then we saw a change in this, in which we learned modified block format. But the third one which we are using nowadays is block format. Okay, this one we are going to see, because this is the format which we are using nowadays in business letter, formal letter, everywhere. Okay, not in case of informal letter. Let me tell you very clearly that in case of informal letter, there is no rule, there is no format. You can use anything, because informal letter is basically to your relatives, to your dear ones. There is no need of any kind of format. You can will be very casual, informal there. Okay, so let us see what are the 10 points that we need to see here, which we have to follow strictly. So first point that we can see here is our headings and letter or letterhead. As we know that when we talk about business letter, always we know that it is printed on a letterhead. Okay, so on letterhead, on the upper side, we can see there is a heading or letterhead. We have the name of the company. Okay, for example, contains the company name and details, like address of the company, where it formed, and its registration number. All these things are given on the letterhead. Okay, at the top center, we can see it here only, this place. Okay, or it will be an heading. But as I am talking about only business letter here, but in case of formal letter, okay, where you are not writing business, that is not a business letter. Okay, if you are writing, like you are writing an application to your HOD, or you are writing an application to your principal, so, or your to the manager, okay, that time what you need to do, that time you are not a company. Okay, you are not writing in a company or letterhead, that time you are writing in a simple, in a paper. So at that time, first thing that you need to do here is that, now you don't have to give the address of your company, you have to give the address, okay, of the sender. Like you are the sender, you will be giving your address only. Okay, so for example, so first thing that you will have to do here in the first heading is sender's address. Okay, first thing you need to do is sender's, sender will be you, because you are writing the letter. So first thing you will have to do is sender's address. And remember my dear friends, everything, whatever you are writing, it should be in a margin, and that will be left margin. No need to write on right margin, no need to give any kind of indent or any kind of space, and then you are starting from here. Like earlier days we used to do to the manager. Okay, now to is here and we are starting the from this place, we are giving space. So this kind of things should be avoided. If you are starting something from left alignment only, the margin should be followed. Okay, alignment should always be on the left side only. Don't go to right side, don't give any kind of space. All the things, all the new sentences will be starting from the left side only. Remember my difference. Okay, now here sender's address, what I am telling you, are the sender, you will be giving your address only. So your address should be completed in one line or two line. Don't compel it to take some three or four lines. Just complete it in one or two or three lines maximum. Try to complete it in two lines actually. Okay. So it is about your formal letter, and from formal letter only it is taken in business letter that instead of giving sender's address, they are giving the company, because company is sending that. That is why sender's address. So here we have understood about the first point, that we have to give the sender's address. In case of you are writing, you will be giving your address. In case a company is writing a letter, then it will be on letterhead, it will be printed, or it will be heading. Okay. Now last is reference number. In case of business letter, actually mostly we will see that in case of business letter, they are giving always reference number. Reference number where we are putting some there are some code given there. Okay. For example, it helps in linking up the chain of letters going out of the organization, or identifying the memos issued by a department of the organization. So for example, reference, this is kind of example of reference, in which reference 56. 56 stands for the number given to the department. That means a department is there to which is writing there. Okay. So for that department is giving its reference. Instead of writing the whole department name, it is writing only the code 56. Next is PD. That is the department, again the short form personnel department. It is giving in a short form PD. Now 26. 26 is the number allotted to the person addressed. Now it is writing to whom the person is, they are addressing about which person. That is what it is given. So this kind of code which is written by a business letter. Okay. So if you are writing business letter, you will have to give reference number. Whenever you will writing a business letter, you will understand it very clearly. Okay. If you are not getting it, you will be getting it later when you are writing a business letter. Okay. Because you know the company's code there. You will be knowing the code which you have given to your business departments. Okay. Now if you are not writing a business letter, then you need not give reference number. For example, you are writing an application to your HOD, branch manager or principal, need not give any kind of reference number. I hope you got this clear to you. Next we will see that after sender's address. Okay. After first point that we have seen, sender's address. Next point, always give whatever point I am telling you, give a line space, and after that next point will be there. So date. Now here, as we know that we have to write, note down date. How to write a date? Remember my dear friends, whenever you are writing a date, for example, consider any date, March 21st March. So how we will be writing it? March 21 2018. So this way we will be writing a letter date. Okay. No need to write the date word here, just start with writing the date. Okay. For example, I am writing here also. How I will be writing date is March 20, that is 20th March. Okay. And then 2018, this is the year. Here I have written month at first you have to write, then date, and then year. This will be the format. Now some people will be asking that, sir, we can also write date and then month and then year, because we have always read this, we have always learned this. Yes, you are correct. You can write at first date and then month and then year. That is also correct. But what is the trend nowadays people following? Okay, that we need to follow also. We don't need to go with the orthodox feeling that what we have learned earlier, that we have to follow strictly. No, what people are following nowadays, you need to follow that also. Okay. So that's why I'm telling you, that is not wrong if you are writing date, month and year. That is not wrong. But if you write this, then it will be much better. That is what I'm telling you. Next thing, after writing date, we'll have to write inside address. Inside address, that means it is a receiver's address. You can write it receiver's address. That means whom you are sending. Okay. For example, you are writing this letter to the principal. So the principal is what? He is the receiver. Then it will be the receiver address. So you will be writing like what? The principal. Now you need not write to. Okay. Because it is always understood that nowadays that we are writing about the receiver only, address of the addressee. That is why it is not required to write to there. It is optional nowadays. So you can start with direct the principal or the manager. Okay. In this way we can say we need not write to the manager or to the principal. The principal and then your school like DPS school. Okay, then Delhi. This is what in a very short way we have written the address of the addressee to whom we are addressing. So this is what a receiver's address is. Okay. Now after completing this, next will be mode of address or salutation. That means now when people will be thinking, sir, after writing address, we used to write subject. Now this again it is what gone days. Okay. Nowadays we are not writing subject at first. We are writing at first salutation and then we are writing subject. Okay, so first thing after completing this we will write dear. Okay, don't take it that I am right giving the space. Okay, I am writing from here only. Dear sir, in case you are the employee of that place. Okay, if you are not employee, if you are a student, then you will be obviously you will be writing respected sir. Okay, I am just considering that you are an employee at that time. What you are writing is dear sir. Or if it is a ma'am, then you will be writing dear sir or ma'am. Okay, you need not write sir there, ma'am. And then after that, either you can give a comma or you can give a colon also. It depends on you whether you are writing dear sir comma or dear sir colon. It depends on you. But nowadays people are using both dear sir comma and then dear sir colon. Okay, so it depends on you. So now, as you know that man is addressed as Mr. and woman is addressed as Miss. It is always already clear to you. Let's move on. Next thing that we'll be seeing here is that while giving salutation, how to give salutation. Now, in case of the person, okay. Now, if it is a plural of Mr., then how we will be writing? We'll be writing Messrs. Remember this. Okay, for example, we have also taken an example. Messrs. A, B, C and Sons. Now, in this case, we can understand this. They are not saluting a person only. Okay, they are. It is about plural because it is a partnership form. Especially in partnership form, we will be using Messrs, not Miss. I hope you understood that in case of plural, we will be using Messrs in case of Mr. Okay. Now, apart from that, if you are talking with some person, okay, at that time, if you know that person. Okay, if you know the person, then you will be taking his name. If you don't know the person, you will not take his name. Okay, for example, earlier I told you that we used to write dear sir. Okay, we used to write dear sir and then colon or comma, whatever is this. Okay, you are using. But if you know that person, then it will be dear Mr. Sharma. Because I know that person whom I am writing, then it will dear Mr. Sharma, comma, or colon, whatever you want to use. Okay, or is like example is here also I have given Captain Rana. Why? Because they have some titles. If people have titles, you should use that title. If they don't have title, then obviously you'll be using Mr. Okay, if they don't have titles in that case, but if they have title like Doctor, Professor, Colonel, okay, in these cases you need to write their titles, whatever the ranks or titles they have, you need to write that. Okay, now if you know that person, you have written dear Mr. Sharma, you might be thinking that dear Mr. Rahul Sharma. If it is a Rahul Sharma, why I have written Mr. Sharma? Because I know that person, that's why I am writing dear Mr. Sharma. It seems that I know him very nicely, very closely, that's why I am using dear Mr. Sharma, directly taking his surname. But if we don't know, then we will be using dear sir or dear Mr. Rahul Sharma. Just we are knowing each other, just that's why I am going to take the full name. So it doesn't matter if you are taking full name or if you are taking surname, but if you take surname, then it feels good. Okay, that's why I have told you. So if you know, please try to write dear Mr. Sharma. If you don't know, write dear sir. Now coming to the next, that when a particular person is addressed by their designation, Mr. or Miss, Mr. or Miss is not used. Why? For example, branch manager. Okay, this is actually when I am talking about here, when I was talking about this principal. Okay, now principal, we don't use Mr. or Miss Principal, because we are using the designation. That is why when we are talking, when we are taking the designation, that time we don't need to use any kind of Mr. or Miss. Okay. Now coming after that, now as we have completed salutation, next thing that we have to see here is subject. While writing subject, you should be very brief and quick indication of the thing what you are going to write. Don't write in a whole 2 to 3 lines, because subject is only giving an indication that on what topic are you going to talk about. So you have to give in a very brief idea what are you going to talk about. Now after subject, come to the content. Okay, now in content, remember that always, mostly it is 3 paragraph. Okay, so in first paragraph, it will be about introduction. Introduction again contains about your introduction as well as the introduction of the topic on which you are going to speak. So give a brief idea here and give an introduction about yourself also, so that people would be who is right reading your letter, he will be a little bit getting the notification of all the things whatever he is going to read in your letter. Okay, so next thing, when you have given the introduction and idea about the letter, you will be talking about the body. Now in body language, it will be giving all the details of what you are talking about. Okay, details and facts. Okay, why and supporting details, like you want to take leave. So if you are taking leave, why are you taking leave? Okay, what's the problem? There will be supporting details would be there. That is what. Next is your conclusion. So in the conclusion, you will be giving the conclusion. Now while giving the conclusion, you know, some people use so. Don't use this word so. So I don't want to, so I want you, so I want to absent the class, so I hope you will be doing this. So all these things, wherever you are using so and so, you are not giving the conclusion. Remember my dear friends, don't use this word so. I won't be able to attend the class, leave it. The better you use I, therefore request you, or you can use I hope that you will, all these things you can use these things. Okay, avoid the using the word of so. Okay, leave this word and then use this kind of words at the conclusion. Even you can also thank the person whom you are writing, like I will be grateful to you, I will be thankful to you. This kind of sentences you can use here. After completing this, nowadays if you have like what I told you in conclusion para, you can also give I will be grateful to you. Once we have used grateful to you, it is not necessary that you will be using thank you after saying I will be grateful to you. So better if you have used I will be grateful to you, don't use this word thank you again after completion of your paragraphs. If you have once used, if you have not used, in that case you can use thank you, otherwise don't use. Now after completion of your paragraphs, then complimentary clause will be there. In complimentary clause, we use either yours faithfully or yours sincere. Most important thing that you need to see here is many people use yours. Your, that is apostrophe s. Remember that your never has apostrophe s. You need to know this. Okay, so yours faithfully or yours sincerely. Now what is the difference between yours faithfully and yours sincerely is that if you know the person, you will be using yours sincerely. Okay, that will be yours sincerely if you know the person. Okay, used when the name is used in the salutation. Again, this what here are also written. When you write the name, when you know the person, that time you are writing the name in the salutation. When you don't know the name, you will be using dear sir. At that time, you will have to use yours faithfully. When you don't know, okay, don't know the person, at that time you will be using yours faithfully. Next, we will see signature. After completion of your yours faithfully, you will have to do the signature. If you are writing in a page, at that time at first write your name at first. Okay, letter, At first write your name, and above your name now give your signature. Okay, because at first signature comes, but as you are not signing over there, at first you can write name there, because if you are typing on a computer at that time, what will you do? You can't sign there. No, at first you will have to write name, and then you will have to take printout, and after that you will have to sign over there. Okay, so this is what, before the name your signature comes, you should know there that. Okay, and it should be cross signature again. Okay, now next, while you're writing your name, you should also give your details. Okay, detail of the person, like you are from which department, what is your designation. Okay, all these things you should be providing there. And so these are the 10 things that we can see. And the last point, this also is actually is the 10th number only, but we have taken the number of reference, that is why it has come to 11th point, otherwise it is 10 points. So reference section, we usually use enclosures or courtesy copies. Okay, in enclosures, like we are using medical certificates, why we are taking leave and all these things. So in enclosure is like an attachment only. So whenever we are talking about attachments or enclosures, whatever we are enclosing with that application, that is what enclosure is. Okay, and that is courtesy copies. Some courtesy copies we use, that is what. Okay, some people also use postscript. This postscript is very rare, many people are not using these things, but still, to tell you, I have used this also. So it is used for conveying a small bit of information that is not a part of main message of the letter. For example, a friendly inquiry. A friendly inquiry, if you are inquiring about something, that is what, postscript. Okay, but after the script, you are using something very small inquiry you have, that is what, if you are want to ask them at that time, you can use this postscript. Okay, otherwise it is not necessary. So these are the things that are very important that you need to know. I hope you have understood. And one more time, I have again given the whole thing, whatever I have taught you from first to 10th point, I have given this in this whole thing. Now note down this format. Once you note down this format, I assure you that wherever you are going to write the letter in the format, you will always getting good marks, you will be always getting good image if you are writing in this format, because a letter contains, or a letter reflects, the character of a person. What character do you have? It is reflected from your writing skills, especially in case of letter writing. So I hope you have understood all the things. Once again, I am repeating all the things. Okay, at first give sender address, and then your date, then write to address, that means receiver's address, and then salutation, and after that subject, and after that your content, in which there will be three paragraph: introductory, body, and concluding paragraph. After that, complimentary closing. So complimentary closing can be anything: sincerely, respectfully, regards, and after that signature, sender's name, and his details like designation and office, all these things, and the last one is enclosures. So this is all from my side. I hope you have understood about the writing letter. If you like the video, please do like and also subscribe to channel, because if you more subscribe to the channel, we will be very happy. I will be bringing more videos to you. Okay, thank you for watching. Take care.